What's up, guys? Arden here with the L House Ariel, and today we're going to be talking about SSDs. There's a lot to get through, so I'm going to be using some notes. In the past year, I've learned a lot about why hard drives are slow. Often it's not the connection. Take, for example, this Seagate 8TB drive. It is USB 3, but USB 3 is about 4 times as fast as this drive. This goes for your little WDMI passports as well. When they're USB 3, the speed of them is limited by the drive itself, not by the connection. You're not like, oh, this is the newest, fastest USB. It doesn't matter. The spinning drive is the bottleneck. So unless you pick up something like a Western Digital MyBook Duo or a LaCie Too Big Dock, they have multiple drives and they're used in what's called a RAID array to leverage the fact that you have multiple drives and they can make it faster. They can deliver you more data through the same size of pipe, that USB 3 connection. But RAID, we're not going to get into RAID. That's a whole other video. So back to SSDs. I reviewed the Samsung T5 external SSD in this video. It sucked and I'm not sure why. We should have easily reached the 400 megabyte per second read and write speed that the T5 is rated for and usually tests at, but I don't know really what happened there. Honestly, instead of the Samsung T5, I would pick up something like an external, just standard external SSD. This is a Pro variant. You can also get 860 Evos from Samsung. They are gray, the Pro is red. These are more expensive, slightly more reliable, just a hair faster. These are totally fine for 90% of applications. So what you can do is you can take this and pick up a USB SATA cable. So you can plug this in, just like that. And then this has a USB end. This particular cable is USB-C. You plug it in and then you can plug this into your computer. It's fine. It's bus powered. It is super fast. And you don't need to spend money on an enclosure or some specific thing. You can just have this. These are decently durable. Just take care of it. But this will hold your data and will make for a fast, high capacity, affordable drive for backup or data or working in a pinch. And it'll be the best bang for your buck. I think these cables are like 20 bucks, 25 bucks. So I also found, you might have seen this situation going on, I found a product from OWC. They make the Mercury Elite Pro Dual Mini. So this is a USB 3.1 Gen 2, so 10 gigabit per second, 2.5 inch hard drive enclosure. It can select to RAID 0 or RAID 1, which is either optimized for speed or redundancy. Either both drives will be exactly the same, or you can split the data between the two drives and it'll operate twice as fast. So this is actually as fast, if not faster, than the Glyph Atom RAID, which is a little SSD kind of like the Samsung T5, but more expensive and a lot faster. This is the same or faster. For 4TB system, it'll come in $100 to $250 cheaper for the same thing, just mind you, with a little bit bigger. But it's bus powered and these things have no moving parts. They are fantastic. It's an aluminum enclosure, good quality. It's great. Can't recommend them anymore. So you buy any two and a half inch drives. You could buy spinning drives and put them in here. I would probably just go for solid state. You could put two 250 gigs in here. That would be pretty affordable. These enclosures are, I think, 105 Canadian plus shipping. So I got 4TB in RAID 0, which is ultra fast, 950 megabytes per second. I just popped these into a Nanook case. They are super durable and you can hand this off to a client or just toss it in your truck. Everything's gonna be fine. There's no moving parts. You're not going to bust it, damage it, or have a failure just because this got knocked around a little bit like you would with a spinning disk. So I do work as a digital loader, which is offloading, making copies of, and producing offload reports of footage that was shot for a professional production. And you have multiple copies to make sure that it is extra safe, because all the money that you spent on making a movie or making a commercial boils down to the footage that you capture, and you need to make extra sure that it's there. So for example, in a shoot day on a commercial, they could hand you 3TB of Arri Alexa footage. And the only way to offload that and have multiple copies with reports and proxies rendered for the very next day is to do that on either a huge, very expensive RAID array, which will be massive and a very large investment, or you can use something like the Mercury Elite Pro Dual Minis, where they're 4TB RAID systems. They're small, they're compact, they're bus powered, and you can offload footage and render off of these like nobody's business. So there are specific differences between the Samsung Pro and Evo SSDs, for example. This applies to iPhones, SD cards, USB sticks, internal SSDs on laptops. And the big difference is what type of NAND flash is inside them. There are 4 main types. There's single level cell, multi-level cell, triple level cell, and quad level cell. Now each one basically multiplies your available storage based on the on one chip. If you have a chip that can hold a gigabyte, a single level cell would hold a gigabyte, but a multi-level cell would hold 2 gigs, and then a triple level cell would hold 4 gigs. Now this allows you to produce the same chip and actually give more storage, but the thing is, it slows it down, it makes it slightly less durable, and increases your likelihood of errors when you go from single to multi to triple to quad level cell. Now even these are multi, so they're actually two levels in there, but they are very fast and very reliable. Even a quad level cell is pretty reliable and not likely to fail on you, at least especially when it comes to vibration and power consumption and moving parts. There are certain manufacturers that also have differences in their firmware and the way that they manufacture their hardware and the reliability of that that affects the performance and the longevity of an SSD. But you have to think about what type of SSD it is. You have to look at what type of NAND flash is in there and decide really what's more important. The Evo series is a really good balance. It is not the QVO series, which are, I think, quad level cell. So they are a little bit slower, whereas these ones will have a bit of a speed advantage and last a little bit longer. They can take more data writes without having a failure or a data error. Another thing that I learned recently when looking at a cheap SSD is you can't just use an SSD for long-term data storage. You can't just put a bunch of data on here and put it on the shelf. A SSD is more likely to have data degradation. It's more likely to have the cell, the voltage that is in the cells that stores the data, just drift and change slightly, especially with triple level cell and quad level cell, because the tolerances are much lower. So SSDs do have a tendency to drift over time, but when they are plugged in, the firmware will actually go through and refresh those cells and make sure that they are spot on and that the data is correct. So a functioning SSD is more reliable than an SSD that's sitting on a shelf. If you need to put data on something and then shelf it, you want to use a magnetic spinning drive because it is way less likely to drift or change over years. Don't store data on an SSD and then just shelf it. At least plug it in once every couple months just to check it, leave it overnight, let the firmware sort of do its thing. So what did we learn? SSDs come a lot closer to utilizing the full bandwidth of faster USB connections that we see spinning disks advertised with all the time. Picking up a SATA to USB cable and a bare SSD can be an affordable, small, and lightweight solution with lots of storage in a pinch. SSDs are not forever solutions. Definitely, if you're going to put data on one and put it on a shelf, have that data backed up to a different location. And look into what type of NAND flash is in an SSD before you buy it. Look at the application. If you see a 1 or 2 or 4 terabyte SSD that's on sale, it looks like a really cheap drive. It's possible that that's triple or quad level cell, so just be aware of that. Don't rely on it completely if it's triple or quad level. Anyway, hopefully you found this useful. If you did, drop a comment or a like. I will get back to your questions there. Thank you for watching. My name is Arden Shibley for Yellow House Ariel, and I will see you in the next video.